everyone, welcome to Coolzy.com. Today we're going to try and answer as many questions as possible that you guys have put through our social media comments and through our customer service channels. You want to see how a Coolzy compares against a portable air conditioner. What we've done here is we've set up two equivalent rooms in our offices which are identical for all intents and purposes, and we've put a bed in each room so that we can see what the temperature is on the bed. Remember, the philosophy of Coolzy is we're not trying to cool the entire room, we just want to cool the space people are inhabiting, and in this instance, we want to cool the bed. In here, we have one of the top-rated portable aircons because we don't want to hold ourselves to a standard that we don't believe we match up to. And on this side, we've got a Coolzy-Pro. So come on and have a look. We're going to measure noise, temperature, energy consumption, and size. So have a look. In here, you can see the Coolzy is focused on the bed. It's been running for a couple of minutes. I've got a sound meter here, which I'm going to place 1.2 meters from the unit, and we'll do 1.2 meters next door as well. I've got an infrared FLIR camera here, so we'll be able to measure the temperature of the bed. The room itself is around about low 30s, so somewhere in the low 30 degree Celsius mark. But the bed itself, let's have a look. Now remember, Coolzy doesn't try and cool the entire room. So on the bed, we're getting around 27 degrees, 27 and a half degrees. Behind the bed, you can see it's blazing hot. And that's because there's a window behind here with the sun shining directly in from the west. Now come have a look at the sound. Now the unit is at it's at medium fan speed, so we'd expect around 50 decibels from the sound meter. There is a bit of environmental noise, particularly the unit running next door. But 50 decibels, I don't have to speak very loud for us to have a conversation. If there was a second person here, you could easily speak at a reasonable volume and have a nice, easy conversation. Energy consumption, come and have a look. And what was the energy consumption there?
333 watts.
333 watts. So super low, about the same as three or four old light bulbs. Now, let's go have a look next door. This unit is one of the traditional portables available commercially. It is one of the top rated units. It's supposedly one of the most quiet units, one of the most efficient. Its philosophy is it tries to mix all of the air in the room and thereby cool the entire room. So let's see how effective it is. It's been running for about half an hour. Now we are piping the warm air out of the room with this unit. It's attached to the bottom of the door. We'll set up the sound meter at 1.2 meters. From the unit. So that's about 56 and a half decibels. So for those of you that know anything about sound energy, for every 3 decibels you go up, the noise roughly doubles. And it's noticeably louder in here. I can feel that I have to speak louder to be able to hold a conversation. If there was a second person here, we'd have to speak quite loudly to be able to talk. Now, the temperature. We'll use our infrared camera. You can see the bed is around about 27 and a half, high 27 degrees Celsius. Yes, it's true that the entire room is noticeably cooler. However, the temperature and the beds are comparable. And let's have a look at the energy consumption. So the energy consumption there is about 1.32 kilowatts. So that's roughly, what, three, four times more energy than we were using next door. So for three or four times the electricity, you're getting a very similar result on the bed. Yes, the room is cooler in general. However, it's cost you almost four times more in electricity. The unit itself is one of the highest priced on the market. So you've spent another $500 on the actual unit itself. If you have a look at the unit, it's physically larger, which means in winter when you're not using it, you've got to store this big thing somewhere, and it's double the weight. In fact, I think it might be slightly more than double the weight. Ours is 15 kilos, this one's about 30, 32 kilos. So that gives you a sense of where a Coolzy sits in comparison to other units. So the Coolzy was not only quieter, significantly quieter, the temperature in the bed was comparable, roughly the same. The Coolzy was using about a quarter of the energy, or just over a quarter of the energy, and the Coolzy was much smaller. So hopefully that's helpful. And I guess if you're considering cooling an entire room, a better option might be a split system rather than one of the traditional portables. If you can't afford a split system, or if your landlord won't put one in for you, or if you value using less energy for the environment, then the Coolzy is probably the more appropriate solution. So hopefully that's helpful. All the best, and thanks for following.